All right, so I figured we would jump into a two-man play against a random competitive opponent to end the play testing session. And we're on the play and we got a pretty decent hand. So to recap, we beat a Jund player who made a few mistakes, and we lost to an Omniscience player. The Omni deck's just unbeatable, man. That's basically what happened. Just can't beat that deck. No one can. As for this hand, it's pretty sweet. Experiment one. Oh no. Our deck is slow. Those are not really the draws we wanted either. Well, let's see what happens. Gyre Sage is really the least scary thing that he could have played this turn. I was bracing for Burning Tree, Burning Tree, Burning Tree, Mayor of Averbrook. You're dead. But he didn't have that, which is sweet. And we have Archdruid, which can generate a lot of mana. Next turn, we can play Visionary and Garrick and make a beast. And the Visionary is like a pretty good blocker. They will be good blockers. It's gonna be a boar. Burning Tree. Is this gonna be a boar as well? Gyre Sage is pretty good. Yeah, jeez. Jeez. I don't know what to say other than jeez. Oh my goodness. More? Another Burning Tree. Stranglerood Geist. Jeez. That's all I can say. Well, we don't have really good blocks this turn. Next turn, though. Here's a Faith's Reward. So if we can, like, survive this one turn, we could trade everything across. We'll see what happens. Garrick making a beast. Yeah, it just seems kind of unrealistic at this point. This is like kind of showing what Standard is actually like. Standard is really, really, really powerful. This is his third turn, and he's got all this stuff in play. In order to be able to compete with starts like that, well, we didn't have a one drop, but we were on the play, so it kind of evens out. But I mean, point is, decks are really fast and competitive and aggressive. And our deck is like borderline up there, so this is why I started in the tournament practice room, and this is why we don't have a sideboard also, because I just want to combo as much as possible, and I don't want to necessarily go against the top tier decks. I want to play against other random brews just for the mental exercise, really. But might as well try to beat the top decks a couple times, see what happens. So what is he gonna do? The hope is that he just sends everything at Garrick so that we can survive a turn, and then next turn we can like set up pretty good blocks and Faith's Reward maybe. Three, four, five. What do we want to draw here? It's unclear. More Faith's Rewards. It's an experiment one, which doesn't do a whole lot. Gyre Sage evolves it, but is not the scariest. So we'll see how he attacks. He's sending at Garrick. Sending everyone at Garrick. Garrick is dead. You got Garrick. We're not. We definitely. Oh, we can eat his Burning Tree, actually. And then we could block with a couple Visionaries. We could throw two Visionaries. No, we would need a double chump in order to save the Garrick. Double chumping. Well, we could trade with the Stranglerroot, block here. Next turn, we could play another Garrick and make another beast. I think that we need the Visionaries though, with like a Faith's Reward in order to win this. I believe so. So I'm thinking I'm just gonna let that happen. So three, four. We could play Garrick and make another beast. We could also Blood Throne. Oh, we don't even have white. Well, the plan is to Ghost Quarter for white. Three, four, five. This is tough. We could just pass the turn and then brace for impact, basically. I think that's what we want to do. Like, playing a Garrick here is basically just treading water, which I think is fine, but I think we want to get the mana acceleration from this, and we want to get the extra cards from the Elvish Visionaries. So, as for how we're actually going to block this turn, it may just be a lot of chump blocking. Maybe trade if we can trade at all. I don't think we're gonna die. Seems pretty unlikely. But this faith reward is going to have to be super money. It's going to bring our dudes back. We're bound to keep our beast because we'll probably block the Stranglehold Geist or something smaller. And then maybe if you grow something, we'll double block. Otherwise, we're just going to like jump across. Faith reward, drawing two cards, and ramping. And then we can play a Garrick, make another beast, play a Bloodthrown Vampire. Brace for impact again. Going to be tough, but it doesn't look unwinnable. It looks like it's going to be tough. Alright, so he has finally come alive. I think he might be like double killing or something. He's tapping mana for a boar, so everything's evolving. It's just super crazy, like why is this all standard legal? Why is this all standard legal? It's crazy, it's really crazy. Game plan is to faith reward everything. And try not to die. So we can block Strangle Root just so that our guy survives. Or we could block... Oh, here's what we'll do. We'll trade... Well, was it better to trade the beast this turn and then trade it again next turn? Block here. Probably better just to... Hump this Gyre Sage. Trade here. Chump here, take 6, go to 5. His Stranglehold Geist will come back. We want everything to die so that everything comes back, so a double block didn't really make sense. He may have Giant Growth. It's one of his last cards. I think that he's just double queuing, which is something that you can kind of afford to do when you're playing such a crazy deck. So how do we actually win this? Pretty unclear. We're gonna need the cards we draw to be absolutely bonkers. We can just chain faith rewards and maybe win that way. Here's another blood throne or another elvish archdruid, which is actually a really good draw. Soul of the Harvest, interesting. So we go 3 for another archdruid, and then 4, 5, 6. 3. We could play Soul and then an Archdruid. And then we'll have 4 blockers. 4 blockers kills us. That's not enough. We would need, in order for that to work, yeah, 4, no, well, 5 blockers, right? Yeah, well, 5 blockers, 3, 4, 5, so we could survive. We could, yeah, okay. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Do we not actually have enough mana? Do we need to play an Archdruid first? No. 3, here we go. 3, 4, 5, 6. Soul of the Harvest. Archdruid. Draw a card. Pass the turn. Hope, basically. We're dead to any kind of tricks or anything like that. So, we just hope. Okay, there's a Wolf Run, which is non-lethal. Is it lethal? No, it shouldn't be. Well, we've got a bunch of 3-3s, so we can actually trade off pretty well. Garrick is going to hump the biggest dude. And then we're going to go 3-3s across the table. If he can kill one of our Archdruids, our House of Cards is just going to crumble down. We're also dead to a Giant Growth effect. So the hope is he just has absolutely nothing. Searing Spirit or Giant Growth is going to kill us. Maybe should have blocked this Stranglehold Geist. I don't know if that makes a difference. Well, we're not dead yet. And we're still not dead. 1. So what do we want to do here? 3, 4, 5. Garrick. Make a 3-3 pass. 3, 4, 5. Probably just play a Soul of the Harvest. Well, if we minus 3, we could... How do we win the fastest? So much for me saying the deck wasn't competitive. Who knows? We beat a pretty blistering... I'm not going to say we beat it. But we're in a good spot against a really blistering start. I like playing Garrick here. Shout out to having all 4 Bloodthrown Vampires. I like playing Garrick, making a beast, and attacking with Soul of the Harvest. Are we going to die if we do this? I don't think so. I may get punished in the coldest way. If he, like, plays two haste guys, it seems pretty unlikely. Like, if he has Searing Spear, we're already dead. Play a land, two haste guys, or something like that. He does nothing, okay? So let's draw cards. Try to kill him this turn. There's a Faith Reward. We don't have a Haste Goblin, though. So we can't straight up kill him. We can 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We can't haste him out either. One. There's not really a reason to expend a Faith Reward this turn. Well, you know what? We might as well see if we hit a Ghost Quarter. Like, we're not out of cards yet, so we can play an Arbor Elf. This generates mana. Okay, we can actually win this turn. Seems that way. Two. We may be able to win this turn. Well, we can haste him out. Yeah, we should be able to win this turn. We'd have to... Do we have the mana to do this? Yeah, we should. Should I have tapped this? Well, this taps for mana anyway, so might as well play it. There's another Arbor Elf, which taps for mana, so we might as well play it. And I believe we can attack and kill him at this point. I don't have a problem showing him our combo, though. Oh, he just scooped. We won, actually. Crazy. We beat a Blistering Start. We have no sideboard. I don't know that I would want a sideboard anyways if we had one. I mean, how would we sideboard here? This has been the experiment the entire time. When building the sideboard. I really don't want to change anything. I mean, I keep thinking that a fourth Garrick would be good, so maybe we just want a fourth in the main, but I don't want to cut anything either. Oh, we still have the Blood Artist. Whoops, I meant to cut that. But I guess it's maybe worth having in the deck, just so you can beat Fogs and stuff like that. But it seems unnecessary. Generally unnecessary. And having Visionaries is really good, because they're an awesome smoother.